remember we did a late night prom about 5-6 years ago. So the prom started about 10 o'clock. And Ollie, as we call him, was conducting the BBC Symphony Orchestra at a 7 o'clock prom. And after our rehearsal later that afternoon, a lot of our players went and bought tickets to sit behind the stage in the Albert Hall so they could see him conduct. And as you know, we're an orchestra that often is known for perhaps not wanting to work with conductors or not needing to work with conductors, but here were our players actually actively wanting to see the great man conduct.
Always very charming and completely and utterly musical. He knows exactly what he wants and he hears everything.
I think he's got about the best pair of ears I think I've ever worked with, really.
I do remember one time where there was a big cluster chord in a piece, massive orchestra playing, big cluster chord, lots of notes, which to me felt just like rah. And Ollie stops and he goes, third horn, it's not supposed to be C natural. And he goes, sorry, yeah. Amazing, amazing ear.
He wanted to base a programme around the Berg Chamber Concerto for violin and piano. That's the core work and his starting point. And then he's put a beautiful little wind serenade by Mozart in there as well. And I'm glad to say his own Requiem Songs for Sue, absolutely beautiful work for soprano Claire Booth, who actually gave the premiere, who's going to be with us. He's chosen a piece by Stravinsky that is hardly ever performed, called Ode. And again, we're starting that programme with some Mozart, the Masonic funeral music, alongside Tippett's Concerto for Orchestra. And then Ollie's Violin Concerto, possibly one of his most performed pieces. Britten Sinfonia is a chamber orchestra, but predominantly we work without conductor. There's a chamber music ethos that runs throughout everything that we do. That said, for particular repertoire, we do bring in conductors.
He really conducts the back desks in the orchestra. He doesn't just relate to the people around him.
He is so clear, so precise, and leaves you in no doubt as to where to play and when to play. And if you make a mistake, it's your fault. It's not because he hasn't been clear.
The way he knits his harmonies together, the way the harmonies shift, it's so beautifully crafted and immediate. There's no question that it has an immediate effect on the audiences and the players who hear his music. ¶¶